Attica is a rough place. It's very cold, and I'm not just speaking about, you know, the walls. I'm talking about just, you know, the vibe, the energy that you get from everyone. You pretty much have to be a strong individual to survive here. You might just got here in the facility. You don't really know anybody. So I might try to be your friend just to see what I can get out of you, see what type of person you are, see what you're in prison for. People do take advantage of you. You know, they will, you know, ask you for a candy bar. And then from there, it goes to, let me wear a pair of your sneakers, you know, and then you don't get them back. And then once you don't, you know, do anything but from that, then it's just open season. Guys are taking your commissary. They might take your TV. It's like a jungle. It really is. You know how, like, the lions prey on the weak, and they're just barely surviving in here.
Ska jag spela in?
Ja, spela.
I wish I fly like a bird. Fight like a bee. Run like a bull.
One more, yeah. Her i Norge så går vi ut fra tanken om at vi her som straff, ikke for å straffes. Så vi har fått straffet vår av retten, og da må vi være her i fengselet en periode. Og vi skal jo ikke straffes noe mer her inne. Så det elementet av hevn, da, det tatt vekk. Det står jo ganske sterkt ellers i hvert fall i USA.
La det pus!
Vi har jo forstått mange prinsipper, men jeg synes de to mest sentrale det dette med normalitet, at, at fengselet skal ligne så mye som mulig på samfunnet på utsiden, men også dette med at vi skal behandle de innsatte på en human måte.
Sett med andre øyer utenifra, så kan det virke dette at vi har det for bra. Men til syvende og sist så må vi forstå at vi sitter jo inne. Vår frihet begrenset. Men behandler du et menneske dårlig, hva forventer du det mennesket skal bli der ute? At i Norge satser de på å rehabilitere mennesker i stedet for å tråkke dem enda lengre ned, synes jeg ikke det for snill. Jeg synes dette en bra tiltak. Dette gir muligheter. Dette skaper faktisk også minsker kriminalitet.
Arbeidsoppgavene synes jeg veldig innholdsrike og meningsfylte. Det å få lov til å legge opp en soningsplan for en innsatt. Få lov til å følge en innsatt fra A til Å.
Jeg jobbet i 14 år i et annet fengsel som snekrer paller. Hva skal du med det når du kommer ut fra fengselet? Å være en reser på å produsere paller? Eller kålkasser eller noe sånn idiotjobb? Jeg synes at det må være viktig at de har noen de kan bruke.
Jeg ønsker å gjøre noe som samfunnsnyttig. Og det å kunne jobbe med mennesker og menneskelig endring, at de skal kunne leve et normalt liv etterpå, som til gavn både for den innsatte og for samfunnet. Og samme også da med å forsøke å eksportere noen av de ideene som virker da i Norden, til et annet land, for jeg har tro på at grunnelementene her vil også virke i andre land. Det det som på en måte jeg synes spennende. Hvis dette kan forandre livet til om så bare en innsatt i USA, så det på en måte verdt å ta den reisen, altså. Aldale, looking at this cell block is to me a little bit unusual, actually. We also have in Norway these kind of corridors, but we have probably a larger degree of privacy.
Actually, we're going to more cells that have open fronts. We're expanding the field of view so we can maintain the care, custody, and control of the individuals within. We do allow the inmates to put a blanket up when they're using the bathroom halfway, but we want to be able to see them.
Okay.
Well, it's kind of inhumane.
Yeah.
You know, it's inhumane, right? You asked me to, like, I'm using the toilet, but you walk by and you're staring at me. Like, it's very degrading, and yeah. You know, it does something to the soul of a person.
I come to work, I do my job, I know that I'm doing my job correctly. I don't know if I directly affect any inmate in a positive way on a daily basis. I just do my job like I'm supposed to. And my goal is to go home every day. So every day that I go home, that's the reward that I get. I get to see my kids again.
Here I have some more hooks where clothes go into. And like I said, utilizing every space. Just bought these bananas at commissary yesterday. So this is really the only place where I can put them where they won't squish and go bad on me. Then under the bed, you want to utilize the space under the bed. I got a bin here where I keep food that I purchased at commissary. Some tortillas, peanut butter, canned goods was not allowed anymore. They just banned these. So now we're allowed pouches. I just purchased these yesterday.
Her er da klær og kjøleskap. Så har vi da ja, jakker. Her er da lite bad. Knøtt lite.
Thank you guys for your willingness to participate in this assignment. What we would like you to do is to think openly, in a way, draw up the ideal prison. It's still going to be a prison. It's still going to be a place where you're deprived of your freedom. So that's the frame. But what would it look like in a way? You can make some drawings, you can make some notes, but we'd like your thoughts.
So we could come up with any concept of any prison that we can imagine.
Gotcha.
All right. A pastoral view where you know, it's like a campus.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, it's a jail, yes, a facility, but a campus.
Put some greenery around here. Remember, look, when so
you don't really have to look at jail cells. You don't have to look at
bars.
You got rooms.
Rooms. Couch, bed, everything. You know.
Doors.
So we're gonna just take you piece by piece. First, we're gonna start with the security, right? There's no walls in this facility, no bars, it's more of a campus setting. We thought about having like ID cards where you go to the building and you have to check in. And right on your ID card is like a computer chip and it logs you in at what time you're there. So you're being monitored everywhere you go. We spoke about having more access to secondary education, such as college, associates, bachelor's, master's degree programs, and if you choose so, a doctorate program. They'll become not only upstanding citizens, but productive members, taxpaying members, individuals that will be putting back into the pot instead of taking it out. You pay a dollar today, you save 10 tomorrow.
Now, I know you only had an hour, so you didn't have a chance to think out everything in this. Did you think at all about what society as a whole, how would this go over, do you think?
I think 80% of prisoners get released. So who do you want coming home to live next door to you? You want somebody who has took education programs or vacation programs and has bettered themselves, or somebody who hasn't learned anything and get released and he's your neighbor?
We put up a wall. Okay. Move the shower into the room or the cell, but we take away the phone, then you have Halden prison. That's how it is. Maximum security prison in Norway.
And do you take international transfers?
I was at Halden prison in March of 2012. I said at the time that if I was to pick five or six guys from Attica's honor block and told them to draw up the prison of your dreams, they would probably come up with some kind of a Halden model. Well, you nailed it, just so you know. And at the time in 2012, I was quite skeptical about whether or not this is gonna work or not. So now I said, I'd like to go back and see it in 5 years. It's been 4 years. Since I was there, they've had one incident which we would consider a serious assault on an inmate. Inmate in a woodworking shop hit another inmate with a thing of wood. So does it work? The results are what they are. When's the last time we had an assault on an inmate here? Tuesday. No, so it's just, my point is that in that snapshot of a place, it does work. Whether we could replicate it here or not, I don't know. So, yep, right.
Anything's possible. Extremely difficult. Finances are a huge part of it. Our political system is also extremely complex and difficult to navigate.
Jeg har truffet mange positive, endringsvillige mennesker. Men jeg har også truffet på en måte gode mennesker som jobber I feil system. Altså, en god kriminalomsorg gir jo kjempegevinster for samfunnet på lang sikt, og det undres meg over at amerikanerne da ikke på en måte tar det perspektivet innover seg, men så, I hvert fall som system, såpass straffeorientert. Det undres jeg over.